let us discuss the concept of a weighing machine. A weighing machine is a device which is used to measure weight. So many of you might have a weighing machine at your home on which when you stand, say if a boy stands on a weighing machine, due to the weight, it pushes the weighing machine in downward direction with a normal reaction and weighing machine also reacted with the same force N. So this weighing machine is constructed in such a way so as to measure the force applied on it. So when you stand on a weighing machine, due to the normal reaction applied by you on the surface of machine, its needle will deflect and gives you the measurement of this normal reaction. And if you are standing at rest, this normal reaction will be equal to your weight. So if this is the weighing machine, and when you stand on it, this is the normal reaction with which you push on the weighing machine. So you can say, a weighing machine always measures the normal reaction acting on it in kilogram force. It measures the reading in kilogram force. You can simply write 1 kilogram force is equal to G Newton. Kilogram force is another unit of force which gives you the idea about what is the weight of a particular mass. Like 1 kilogram force is the weight which 1 kg exerts on a surface due to the effect of gravitational force. So the weight of 1 kilogram body is G Newtons. So we can write if N is the normal reaction acting on a weighing machine then its reading will be, you can simply write the reading of weighing machine is equals to the normal reaction divided by G in kilograms. Your normal reaction is measured in Newton, that divided by G in kilogram, because 1 kilogram force is G in Newton. So in this situation, if we draw the free body diagram of man, so free body diagram of man can be drawn like it is experiencing mg in downward direction and a normal reaction in upward direction. And this is the normal reaction by which the man is also pushing the weighing machine. So weighing machine is intended to read the value of this normal reaction in kilogram force. As this man is at rest, we can simply balance the forces. So we can write N is equals to mg. So here our reading of weighing machine can be written as N by g, it is equals to m. This is the mass which weighing machine is going to read in kilograms. Let us take up an example to understand the concept of weighing machine. Here it is saying that a man of mass 60 kg is standing on a weighing machine inside an elevator which is accelerating up at 2 meters per second square, and we are required to find the reading of weighing machine. We are given that this elevator is going up at an acceleration of 2 meters per second square, and here we are required to find the reading of this weighing machine. Here if we just have a look on the man, we can see that in free body diagram of man, if we just draw the free body diagram of man, he'll experience his weight in downward direction, that is 60 g, and he'll experience a normal reaction in upward direction. Simultaneously, he'll also push the weighing machine in downward direction with the same normal reaction which this machine is going to measure. As we know that weighing machine measures the normal reaction acting on it in kilogram force. Here, if we just talk about the free body diagram of man, he'll experience downward 60 g, upward the normal reaction, and in all the man is going up with an acceleration of 2 meters per second square. We just write down the equation of motion of man. You can simply write the equation of motion as N minus 60 g is equals to 60 a. So here we are getting the value of N as 60 g plus a, that will be 60 multiplied by 10 plus 2, it can be written as 12, that is 720 Newton. This is the normal reaction which is acting on the weighing machine. So we just talk about the reading of weighing machine. The reading of machine can be given as N by G. That will be 720 by 10, you can write it 72 kilogram. So this is the reading of weighing machine. As we have studied, the reading machine only measures the normal reaction acting on it, which is 720 Newton. So we can say that the reading shown by the machine in this situation is more than the actual weight of the man. Now we'll discuss various cases of motion on an elevator, in which if a man is standing on a weighing machine, like if this is an elevator in which there is a weighing machine over which a man is standing, and say if elevator is going up with an acceleration A, so we can simply write from inside, if we observe as G is acting in downward direction, elevator is going up, so in this situation the effective value of gravity can be written as G plus A. That implies if N is the normal reaction acting on the man and the same normal reaction is applied on the weighing machine. So we can draw the free body diagram of the man. It is mg in downward direction, N in upward direction, and the man is going up with the acceleration A. So equation of motion we can write N minus mg is equals to ma. Or N can be written as M into G plus A. This can be directly written as effective gravity as seen from the elevator will be G plus A. So directly we can write normal reaction is equals to M into G plus A. So in this situation, if we calculate the reading of weighing machine, the reading can be written as N by G. So it will be M into G plus A divided by G. This in kilogram, that will be the reading shown by the weighing machine. And you can see in this situation, the value of this reading will be more than the actual mass of man. Similarly, if we consider another case in which inside an elevator, again there is a weighing machine and a man is standing, but the elevator is coming down with an acceleration A. So here you can write directly effective acceleration inside as seen from inside the elevator, the effective gravity can be written as G minus A, because G is acting in downward direction and the lift, this elevator is also going in downward direction with acceleration A. The relative acceleration as seen from inside the elevator will be G minus A. Or you can manage like this in the free body diagram of man, you can write mg in downward direction, N in upward direction. Here also N will be acting between the man and weighing machine. So here it is coming down with A. So we can write mg minus N is equals to ma, or N can be written as m into g minus A. So in this situation, the normal reaction which is read by the weighing machine can be written as, or the reading of weighing machine can be written as N by G. That will be M into G minus A divided by G. This is in kilograms. The weight shown by the weighing machine, that of man. You can see if the elevator is going down, the weight shown by the weighing machine will be less than the weight of man. And say if we consider a third case in which the elevator is moving uniformly, so it is going up or down at a constant velocity. If the elevator is in uniform motion, we can simply state inside gravity effective will be equals to G only. And if we draw the free body diagram of man, it is experiencing N in upward direction and weight in downward direction. And as it is moving uniformly, its acceleration can be written as zero. So here we can write N is equals to mg. So we can directly write the reading of weighing machine will be N by G, that is equals to m kilogram. So if an elevator is moving with uniform velocity, the reading shown by the weighing machine will be the actual weight of man. So these all cases are quite important for analysis of motion of elevator. So be careful about these three cases. Let us take up one more example to understand the concept of weighing machine. Here it says, in the figure, man of mass, 80 kg is holding the cabin of mass, 40 kg, in which he is standing on a weighing machine. This we can see in the figure. We are required to find the reading of weighing machine. Here first, we again analyze the forces acting in the system. Here we can see that man is holding a string which is passing over a pulley and connected to the cabin in which he is standing on a weighing machine. So we can see at every point, due to the weight of a cabin as well as that of man, tensions will act on the system in upward direction. And here, due to the weight of man, he'll push the weighing machine with the normal reaction N, and the weighing machine will also push the man with the upward force N. Here, if we just draw the free body diagram of cabin and man, we can simply state, for cabin, we can see in downward direction, cabin is experiencing its weight, that is 40 g. In upward direction, cabin is experiencing a tension T. Man is also exerting a normal reaction, so we can write a normal reaction in downward direction on cabin. And we can say, as cabin is at rest, these forces must be balanced. So we can simply write the equation as T is equals to 40 g plus N. If we just draw the free body diagram of man, so for man we can say, in upward direction he'll experience a tension, he'll also experience a normal reaction in upward direction which is applied by weighing machine on him, and he'll experience his weight in downward direction, that is 80 g. Again we can say man is also at rest, that means the forces are also balanced, so we can say T plus N is equals to 80 g. If we just add these two equations, we can simply see it will give us 2T is equals to 120 g. That means we are getting the value of tension, that is equals to 1200/2, it is 600 N. Once you get the value of tension, you can directly get the value of normal reaction from this equation. Here we can see normal reaction is T minus 40 g, that is 400. As tension is 600, you can see normal reaction is equals to 200 N. If normal reaction acting on the weighing machine is 200 N, we can directly write down the reading of weighing machine. As we know, reading can be written as N by G. Here it will be given as 200/10, that will be 20 kg. Here you can see, as the actual weight of man is 80 kg, but due to the system shown here, the reading shown by the weighing machine is only 20 kg. It is the answer to this question.